Alright, today I'm going to start with showing you guys how to install Dwarf Fortress and the newest version of DFHack. This is for 0.43.05-beta1. I also play in the original ASCII mode. I don't play with any texture packs or anything like that. Some people enjoy it, makes it a little bit prettier, but I don't know, I've gotten used to playing it without any of that. So, let's get started. So, I'm going to be downloading the Windows version, because I am on a Windows computer right now. DFHack is released for all versions of operating systems, so feel free to download for your respective one. So go ahead and extract Dwarf Fortress after it's downloaded. Alright, and I usually just put it directly into the My Documents folder. So we just drag and drop it into there. Then all we need to do is download DFHack. So I'm getting this from github.com/dfhack and then going to the latest releases that they have. You can see it here. If you need to pause and type that into your web browser, you can do that now. Just click on the main title and it will start the download in a second. Alright, actually, you come down here and click it. See here, there are OS X, Linux, and Windows. Get the 64-bit version if you have a 64-bit computer. Especially because now Dwarf Fortress can run in 64-bit mode, which is pretty cool. So then you just go back to the Documents folder where you had it open, and just copy and paste all of this into it. It's going to ask you to overwrite, I believe, one file. See if it does. Maybe it won't. Yep. Replace the file in the destination. There we go. Now, this is the default configuration. I just leave it at that. You do get a warning when you start up the game about this. Now, here's the icon. This you use it to launch the game as including with the DFHack since you have it installed now. No separate launcher on Linux. Unfortunately, you have to launch through a you have to launch it with the actual DFHack link, not with the Dwarf Fortress Direct. But that all runs in a terminal and is a little bit more in depth. So there's a shortcut. So if you go ahead and click that, there's the link that you're the error that we were talking about. Just go ahead and press enter. Alright, now the reason you're getting the error is because in our main folder, our configuration file is currently named dfhackconfig.example. Where is it at? Yeah, right here. So if you just go ahead and just cut off the example, there you go. Now it's fixed. In this, I would recommend using something like Notepad++ to edit it, and in here you can go through and change anything you want. The main reason I use DFHack is for frames per second optimization, and also to do what's called the Dwarf Manipulator, which is an in-game version of Dwarf Therapist, which allows you to give tasks and take away tasks and do it a lot easier than the built-in tool. The built-in tool is almost unususable. Alright, I'll start streaming just again in just a second, showing you how to actually play the game. Thank you guys, and see you soon.